I went in July, 1 month. It was an exchange from the school, the Circus School of Toulouse, and then with the Circus School of Palestine. And then I came for teaching the trainers there 3 months. And now I'm finishing. My message, okay, living inside the wall is not like living here in Israel. There are no green space, there is no enough water. I don't know, it's another type of life. For me, my message to the Israeli people is to open a little bit their eyes, to get out from this bubble that they are, because the life of the occupier is different from the life of the one of his being occupied. So for me, they have to get out from this bubble, and get out from this bubble doesn't mean that they have to go to the West Bank or they have to start to talk with Palestinians. If they want to do this, it's okay. But before that, they have to understand the situation. And there is a lot of information here in Israel. There is B'Tselem, Breaking the Silence, Alternative Information Center. There are a lot of kinds. There are books, people in internet. You have a lot of information. So maybe the first word is to start to open their eyes in this way. And then if they want to meet the Palestinian, it's okay, they can go. They have to know that a lot of Palestinians, they are angry because they are here in Israel. You are not living with soldiers or someone who is controlling your life. In the West Bank and in Gaza, I don't know in Gaza, but in the West Bank, your life is being controlled all the time. You have a checkpoint, you have a wall, you cannot come here free. Like if you want to go outside of your country, there is a checkpoint in Jordan of the Israeli soldiers. So they are angry because the situation is still there. In Israel is quiet. So they have to know that the first step, they are not easy with them. Me, I came from a Jewish family. I don't think myself, I don't know how what is to be Jewish. I don't know really, I don't consider myself Jewish. I consider myself as a human, Tommy. And a lot of people tell me, don't say that you are a Jewish in Palestine. They make me to feel fear, I have to protect myself. But me, since the first time I came there, I tell the people that I was Jewish, and they understand that they start to understand the difference between Zionist, Israeli, Jewish. It's not all the same, and they have to know that now they look at me as a human being. They don't judge me because I'm Jewish. They understand me. Of course, you cannot go in the street telling I'm Jewish, of course. But it's like in Arabic they say, shway shway, slowly, slowly. For me, the Israeli, they have to start to feel, to leave away this fear of being persecuted. Like all the world is being persecuted. In all the world, they are killing people. And it's not because you are Jewish that you are most special. No. Yes, maybe people hate Jewish, but if, a person say, Finkelstein, he talk about the industry of the Holocaust. He said, if there is a Nazi painting in the wall, I'm not going to feel it's a Nazi painting. No, I continue my life. It's okay. So for me, the main message is open. Get out from your bubble of Israel is beautiful. There are a lot of trees. There are a lot of things. You can live a good life here, but start to think in the other one, because it's not your government that is oppressing them. Your government is taking decisions, but your old soldiers, your friends, your children, your uncles, all the society, or a part of the society, they are participating. So the Palestinians, they only know the soldiers, and they think that you are all the same. Okay. And for the Palestinian, my message is that don't. I understand the hate, but don't think that they are all the same, because this is the problem of the world, that they put all the people in labels and they cannot differentiate a human from another human from another human. So you have to know that all the people, they don't do the army. All the people, they don't think that the Palestinians are terrorists. A lot of people want to change. And so, be open in this way. Palestinian Circus School their work is to open the mind of the Palestinian culture, because in Palestine there are, for me, three problems: the occupation, the culture, because it's a really close culture, and the capitalism, how he's centering. Like the Palestinian circus school, he is taking off the bad energy of the kids, that instead of throwing stones, they do something positive. And in another way, they are opening the mind of the people, and like to be more open, to have like more space to think and to see different point of view, to start to relate, to play together, women, children, and kids and girls. Like it's for me, the work is amazing, because in the same time they are trying to break something in the culture, but at the same time they are doing this in a soft way, like in a slowly. They don't come here and they say this is like this. No, they are like going with the culture. I have a message from the circus school to the Israeli, the Palestinian circus school, that they think that a lot of Israeli want to come to the West Bank, but they have to know that for them, what they say is that the first change is why they want to come to Palestine, if they have to change their society, because they can come here, they can go to Palestine and talk with the people, but what is happening in Israel is that they have, the ones that understand the situation, they have to start to work in Israel for open the mind of the people.